I'm old.
Rick, I imagine you weren't too happy with the rebounding in the first half, and what changed in the second half?
Again, I think that they had a good game plan. We, we're normally like to get into a 70-plus possession game. I think tonight it was a 63 possession game. And first of all, they're extremely well coached. They did what I pretty much expected defensively, that they would really keep it tight. You're watching it, they're really very much inside the three-point line and hoping it will settle early and hope that we're not making shots regularly, and they're in great rebound position to do it. And then on the other end, we put them in some long possessions, and they stayed with it, disciplined, and they had to throw up some tough shots at the end. Those shots bounced anywhere and everywhere, and we were running in as opposed to blocking out. And we're letting balls come over our head, and a couple of times they took it away from us, and give them credit for that. But we got better, certainly in the second half. But I've told our team that's one of the big concerns I have, is can we finish possessions defensively and rebound it the way we need to.
Dalton checked in, I think, about 5 minutes left in the first half and immediately deflected some passes and got y'all on a run. Just how did he change the game with his defense, and how encouraging of a sign is that for him?
Well, it is that, but that's where he should play. But again, part of defense is rebounding. I think he's averaging, around 3 rebounds a game. He's got to rebound. He's got to realize when you're playing basically with a 4 perimeter guys out there, he's got to be a big part of the rebounding solution. But he did. He came up with some deflections, and that's what we've asked him to do, to contain, contest, deflect, and then obviously as time goes on, people are going to work him. I mean, anybody would do that. But it's tough when you know you can score the ball. And we got guys that, you guys know, we can shoot the ball when they're not going in. Guys get a little antsy and they want to get the next one, and when they're as open as we could have been, it's just that deal. But the fact we scored 81 points in a low possession game and against a team that, again, they were disciplined, they threw in some shots at the end that I don't know if we could defend it any better. I wasn't very happy at the end. Joe went for a steal that he can't go through. Santi got beat back door, and we're playing hard, but we got to get smarter in those situations. And again, all these games are to help you build. I thought that Freddie came in, minutes were good there, and then he got hurt. And I was really happy for Cam tonight. I thought he came in and tried to do the things we've talked about with him. Just a couple minutes that JP played, he'll learn a lot from him, believe it or not. But we're getting ready to go to Honolulu and play 3 really tough games, and we're going to need everybody in 3 days.
What allowed Wofford to be so effective from the three-point and get so many open shots from the perimeter?
Well, I'm not saying they were all open. I mean, a couple times they threw in some where they weren't open, and, again, you give them credit for that. Anytime a team gets going, you get beat off the dribble, that puts you into rotation. And they shot – what did they shoot from the three? Yeah, for the game they shot 40%, 11 for 27. And, again, I can tell you 3 off the top of my bat where they made great shots, where they were defended. And so give them credit for that. But they're a good basketball team. They play in a nice league. And when we play teams like this, we want that kind of challenge. We want to see a different style of what people might play. And I thought they were extremely well coached. We told our team that. I was impressed with the fact that they – play a lot of guys' minutes coming into the game. They were playing almost the entire team double-digit minutes tonight. They went with 1, 2, 3, 4, probably not as many, but they still played. Look at their minutes. And so I'm impressed with that. They weren't afraid to go to their bench. And I do think we did wear them down a little bit, but we weren't efficient enough in transition to get some of those easy baskets we need. And we've got to do a better job scoring around the rim. But you know, your team makes shots. They're open. They made them. And, again, they made a couple of real tough ones, which give them credit for it.
Grant, Rob, Mike, Reese. Dalton scores it at a pretty high clip without needing a lot of shots. What makes him an efficient scorer pretty consistently?
I mean, he's confident. It's like tonight he came down and transitioned twice and pulled up. And he said, Coach, they're rhythm threes. I said, we'll make them. You know, I said, on a night when a team's trying to get you to shoot threes, sometimes you can't. You're going to have to fight for a little bit more. And again, anytime we can get a paint touch and a kick out for 3, I'm good with it. I'm really good with it, and because I think we got guys that can shoot it, but you still have to put pressure on people. And but he's got a great feel for it, and again, I don't think he gives himself enough credit to his mid-range game and getting downhill. I don't think he gives himself enough credit for that. And again, he can shoot it, and there's going to be some nights when he really gets it going and starts striping it, but you got to have a feel for the game and how the game's being played and make those adjustments.
I think we've all talked about the offensive ceiling being higher, but you just talked about scoring 82 points in a low possession game. How much pressure does it take off the defense that the offensive floor seems to be higher? You don't have to be perfect.
Again, I would agree with that. I think Jordan Gainey has done a terrific job coming in every game, giving us a spark and getting things going. And I thought he really worked at trying to get downhill, and that's something that's new to him too at this level. I mean, he totally different. But every game he's come in and tried to get down there. I think as his conditioning gets better, he's going to be able to play and be an even better player for longer periods of time. But again, I thought Santi really tried to adjust within the game to get downhill, trying to. But we still got to get our guards driving to score, not just driving to kick out. We've got to put pressure on the rim. We need it from Jonas. We need it from Tobe. We need it from not just Dalton going in around the rim. We need our guards getting downhill. And we missed a couple layups. And again, as long as we shoot them to make them, miss them, I don't have a problem. It's when we throw up shots at hoping it goes in. I'm not big on hope shots.
Rick, what did happen with Freddie injury-wise, and do you expect him back soon?
He's been having some problems with, for the lack of saying it, probably plantar fasciitis. He's been working hard the last couple weeks, and his arches have been hurting him, and he just said he felt like something popped. We'll know. We even actually had a MRI scheduled for him tomorrow morning anyway, so it comes at a good time that he'll be able to get there early in the morning, and we'll see.
With Santi, is he kind of settling into maybe a different role right now with some of the new guys coming in and what he's being asked to do compared to last year?
I think Santi is all about winning, and I'd say the same thing about Josiah. And I think Santi, again, when you go back and look at it, every game, after the Wisconsin game, I was really impressed how many winning plays he made on the defensive end, things that he did that were impressive that don't show up, and sometimes even during the game you take him for granted. I mean, he's going to work hard defensively, and he makes just a lot of plays out there that might not show up in terms of him shooting the ball, and we know he can do that, but he has a great feel for the flow of the game, and he knows when he needs to get aggressive, and he knows how to get other guys involved. He's always thinking the game, but I would say that he and I would tell you Josiah, they would tell you they welcome the fact that we've got some more guys that can help them on the offensive end. They would tell you that there was oftentimes a year ago, and even Jemiah, that they knew that there'd be some nights that we had some lulls. And again, you go back, how many points did Dalton and Jordan score tonight? I mean, they welcome that for them, and it gives them a chance to even, I think, be even more aggressive and you guys know as well as I do that Santi and Z are going to have nights when they'll, as we keep putting it together, they'll figure out what they need to do on the offensive end.
How have you seen Tobe's offensive game develop so that he's not so much just a rebounder?
Well, he's worked on it. He, as we talked about before the season started, he had a good summer last year with USA Basketball that I think helped him confident-wise. And Tobe's got really good touch. And again, the more he plays this game, the better he's going to get. And we're trying to get him to not be such a bull in a china shop and be more finesse guy at times, and because he's got such really good touch. And I think he will probably improve throughout the year, maybe more than any guy on our team offensively as we keep going. And he's all about winning too, and he's going to do what he has to play and has to do to help us win defensively and rebound the ball. But I just – again, I really do expect him to get better offensively as the year goes on. But we got to play. We ran a play for him twice tonight, and he did his job, and the ball wasn't delivered, and that wasn't his fault. And it's guys that have to make that pass. I mean, he did a great job twice when early in the game that we wanted to put some pressure in there, and his teammates didn't get him the ball.
West, then back to Paige for the last one.
Rick, I think most people knew that Jordan Gainey could shoot the ball. In terms of where his overall game is, both on both ends of the floor, how much of that has been a surprise to you, or is this what you thought he could be?
Well, I'll go back. I've said it before. Lamonte Turner and Jordan Bound told me, said, Coach, he can do more than shoot the ball. You know, he told me that. You know, he worked out with him a lot the 2 years that he was at Upstate, and when they were here, you know, when he was at home before he went back to summer school or whatever, he spent a lot of time with those guys. And the biggest thing that's happened for him is his body is changing. I mean, I'm not sure what or how much weight he's put on, but physically he is so much stronger, more explosive than you think. I mean, he had a couple dunks in practice that were like, where did that come from? And I think we'll see it at some point in time this year. He's a good basketball player. He's got a good feel. He's a guy that I think he feels he can get a shot off when he needs to get it off. He's again, he's proven that he can score at three levels. But it's all new to him. And I think as he continues to, with his cardio, fitness, toughness, I think that's going to take him to a different game. His body's going to continue to change over the next year and a half. That's going to help him.
Tonight, Josiah eclipsed 1,000 career points as a Tennessee Vol. Just describe what he's meant to this program and getting those 1,000 career points.
Well, you think about the year he came in as a freshman, and that was probably the toughest year where, you know, we were telling our freshmen this. He played on a team his freshman year that he had to play, and he told them he wasn't ready for it, but he had to do it. And he just talked about how having a chance to sit as a freshman and learn and get your way into it. Well, he didn't get that opportunity. I mean, when you play and have the kind of year that we had where we were really struggling all the way around, it's tough. And I think how resilient he's been and where he's improved his game. I mean, he's done so much with his game, and smart player. He knows, again, he's like Santi, makes a lot of winning plays, and defensively gets his hands. He's got great hands, and his deflections are always great. But he has been a huge, huge part of this program in terms of the culture, everything we're about, what we want this program to represent. And I still want him to continue to get better and better while he's here this next couple months. And I think he will, because he in the worst way, he and Santi, you talk about roles, their role is, and they would tell you, they want to win. Whatever role they have to roll into, if it's different from the past, they're willing to do it. But I think he does give his teammates a lot of confidence, because he and Santi both have been out there a lot, and they know what's going on, and I think those young guys listen to him. If you watch our shoot around today, those guys do a great job of coaching the young guys up, but he's, in the 9 years that I've been here, he's been a big part of those five he's been here, where he's done more than people will ever realize.
Thanks, Coach.
All right, thank you, guys.